备人生生活爱情智慧真理时间科学思想人类生命工作劳动幸福友谊知识成功力量社会价值创造理想道德自然更多
http://mengren/mequals%e8%ab%a/b%e5%a3%ab%e6%af%9%4%e4%b8%9%4%b8%9%e/m/p=6. B3TRASRUAZOFDAO
三宝心法主讲者五静妙翻译者
Mr. Jerome William McCarthy Index
目录
Chapter 1 Why are they congratulating me on receiving the DAO
第一章为什么他们恭喜我求得天道
Chapter 2 What is the DAO
第二章蛇模式到
Chapter 3 What are the three treasures?
第三章何谓三宝
Chapter 4 Why do the introducer and the sponsor take an oath at the altar?
第四章为什么引宝要立愿
Chapter 5 Why I should take an oath before receiving the DAO?
第五章为什么要力求道愿
Chapter 6 How to save human beings
第六章如何求度众生
Chapter 1 Why are they congratulating me on receiving the DAO Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to extend my heartiest congratulations to you for this is your most auspicious dayToday you have received the DAO which is the ultimate aim of existence. All of the Buddhas and saints attained the DAO in the past and, by transcending the limitations of birth and death, had become immortal. That which you have received today is the same DAO. Formerly,One who intended to receive the DAO had to abandon worldly possessions and enjoyments. If he was a king he had to abandon his kingdom. If he was a high official he had to resign his high position, leave his family and go to the remote mountains to seek a master who would transmit the DAO to him.After much suffering he would gradually perfect his conduct, purify his mind and heart and perform many good deeds. For his sincerity, God would send Buddha to transmit the DAO to him. Under such conditions a person able to succeed was hard to find.During that period the DAO was secretly transmitted from one patriarch to another.
第一章为什么他们恭喜我求得天道各位先生太太小姐首先让我衷心地恭喜你们因为今天是你们大喜的日子今天你们得了道道是至宝，道超出了一切。每一位古圣先贤佛祖皆于古代求得天道，故他们能超出生死之界限而永存。今天你们所得的道即同他们其实所得的道一样。在古时人要得到必须弃他在世界上所拥有之一切与享受。假如他是一位皇帝也必须弃他的江山。假如他是一位大他必须舍弃他的爵离开家人入深山寻访能够指点他途径。 传授大道给他的名师。在他经历了千辛万苦之后，同时已将凡心修炼成佛心，并以达至圆满之行为，以及做了许多善事，在他至诚之下，终于感动上天之心，派仙佛来指点，传授大道给他。在如此之情况下，成功者非常稀少。在那时，道是由一代祖师逆传给下一代祖师。
Today we need not go to the remote mountains in order to cultivate ourselves. We may find the means to do so in our own environment. Therefore we must take full advantage of our fortunate circumstances because we are in close proximity to the Tao. Why is the Tao so accessible to us at this time? It is because mankind is facing great calamities which signal the destruction of the human race. What is the cause of these calamities in this modern age? Most people blindly worship technical science and neglect spiritual harmony. They believe that the power of mankind can surpass nature and that science is almighty and can solve all human problems. It would seem as though conscience or soul are only religious terms and have no real existence. Most people do not recognize their true selves, which are indestructible and immortal. Actually, the true self is the master of the mortal body. Today most people have lost their consciences, harming others in order to benefit themselves. Those evils which human beings are now committing will cause great disasters the likes of which have never been witnessed before. This will be the final calamity in which the human race, the immortals of space, and the ghosts in hell will all be destroyed.
然而现在我们不需要到深山去，而我们亦莫修行，何以我们能如此容易就得到这事？因为时代不同了。现在人类面对劫难之来临，末劫就要来到，末劫将会毁灭全人类。劫难是怎样造成的？原因是在此新世纪，多数的人们共盲目崇拜科学，而不注重心灵的完善。他们相信人类的力量能超出大自然，科学是高于一切，科学是万能，科学能解一切人类之问题。而良心、灵性仅是宗教之名词，它永不能实现。人们不认识真理，真理是我们之良心、道心、真我本体，它不不灭，万不长存。它是主持我一生之主人翁。如今世上的众生，大多数失去了真正的良心，他们造一切之罪恶，因此造成了空前绝后之浩劫。我们称它为末劫。在此浩劫中，不仅全世界的众生，同时起天的大仙、地府的鬼魂都要受劫灭。
However, God, of whose essence we are created, is merciful and compassionate and does not desire that the good people be destroyed along with the evil ones. So God has provided that the Tao be disseminated among mankind and has sent the great teachers, Buddha Shikhang and Bodhisattva Yui, to rescue the three kinds of beings, the immortals of space, human beings, and the ghosts in hell, so that they may return to heaven together. Buddha Shikhang and Bodhisattva Yui are under the command of God and are responsible for transmitting the Tao to the three kinds of beings. Their duty is to manage the work called the Last Salvation. This salvation is formless and soundless, and the transmission is performed without preaching. It directly points out the original nature, conscience, or soul of mankind in order that people may realize their true nature and thereby become enlightened.
然而, 是我们灵性的至高无上之母亲上帝, 是非常的慈悲, 一步忍善恶俱焚, 因此降下真道并派名师济公活佛与月慧胡萨降世挽救三曹气天之大仙, 世界的众生, 地府的鬼魂同返天堂, 我们师尊师母二位老大人奉老母的命令, 真传真守普渡三曹, 他们的责任是办理末后一收缘大事, 不立文字教外别传, 直指人心直指人人固有之良心, 灵性使人们见自性而成佛。
When the last calamity arrives, nothing can save mankind except the true way, which is the Tao sent from God. That is why the Tao is widely propagated today to save good people. Ancient people first cultivated themselves and then received the Tao. But today we receive the Tao first and then cultivate ourselves. Therefore, after we have received the Tao, we have to seriously cultivate ourselves. Then we shall automatically be safe from danger, escape from calamities, avoid reincarnation and become saints and Buddhas.
当末劫临头时，没有任何其他方法可以解救众生，除了上帝所降下的唯一之道。因此，现在大道普渡善男信女，古人是先修透的，先修道然后才得道。现在我们是先的后修。 因此得道以后，我们要真正修道，将来自然能逢凶化吉，堕劫比难超生了死，成圣成佛。
Although it is easier for modern people to receive the Tao than it was for past generations, the ability to receive the Tao also depends on each person's condition and background. Today you receive the Tao because you had an affinity with our temple and you and your ancestors have performed many virtuous acts. Possibly you were cultivated in a religion in your previous lives. These conditions allow you to have an affinity for the Tao. Without this affinity, you would never receive it.
虽然今人比古人更易得道，然而亦是各凭各知，根据缘分。今天你们得道皆因与佛有缘，前世有行善积德，祖先有德。 也许前世有修过无。 大宗教或其他宗教，因此使你们今天有人得到，否则将永不能得到。
Chapter 2 What is the Tao, ladies and gentlemen? You have received the Tao today, but what did you actually receive? What is the Tao? The Tao is the source of everything. Tao is the creator and master of the universe. Tao is God, the supreme power. Before the earth and sky existed, before the creation of the universe, the Tao existed. After the universe is annihilated and nothing remains, the Tao will continue to exist and to create and control a new universe. The Tao is limitless, invisible and formless. It cannot be seen, heard, smelled or touched and is beyond the power of human comprehension. Tao activates everything. Yet we cannot see its action. It works without effort, yet nothing left undone. Man usually calls it nature. Nothing can exist without the Tao because everything depends on it. Tao is God and our soul issues from God's essence. We are God's children.
第二章蛇魔是道，各位今天已经得到究竟的是蛇魔，蛇魔是道，道是天地人万物之母，道是宇宙之本源，创造者以及主宰者，道上帝，道至尊至贵之神。当天地还未生之前，一切都未有之前，道已先存在的。当天地毁灭后，道不毁灭，道能再生天地人万物。天地人万物生成了，道其中主宰。道非常奥妙，道无形无相，视而不见，听而不闻，不可嗅，不可捉摸。道超出了人们的想象力而不思议，亦不可言说，一切皆是道所为。然而我见不到道的动作，道是无为而为的，然一切莫不是道所为。人们常称它为自然。假若无道，任何一物不能存在，因为一切都依靠道而的存。道上帝，我们之灵性是上帝所赐，我们是上帝之儿女，上帝是我们之天。
When we speak of the creator of the universe, we call it Tao. When we speak of the ruler of everything, we call it natural law. When we speak of the animating and controlling principle of our being, we call it soul or conscience. When we speak of the creator of our soul, we refer to the Heavenly Mother. In Chinese, she is called Lao Mu. All of the above are one and the same.
当我们从它作为宇宙之本源而言，称它为道。在它作为一切之主宰而言，我们称它为理。当它在我们体内，使我们生存并支配肉体时，我们称它为灵性或良心，因为它赋予我们本性。我们称它为老。这些名称虽异而其意相同，皆指同一物而言。
Now, what you have actually received is the Tao. Tao is everybody's true self. Today you have been initiated by the teacher and the door of your mind has been opened. Now you are able to understand that the body is not your true self. The body is controlled by the Tao within you.
现在你们的就是道，道是每一个人的真我。今天你们以的名师指点开了心窍，现在你认识了肉体并非真正的你，而灵性才是真正的你，那位无形无相的。 然而在支配你的身体的灵性才是真正的你自己。
While you are alive, your soul dwells within your body. As soon as the soul leaves your body, you are dead. Your soul is from God, but your physical body is from your parents. You already had the Tao within you yet did not realize it. Therefore, you have had to search for it and have now been fortunate enough to find a teacher who was able to transmit it to you. Previously you believed that the physical body was your true self and behaved accordingly. You were selfish, committing misdeeds, acts of violence, and overindulging in physical pleasures. This condition repeatedly led you into a reincarnation and endless sufferings. Now you understand that your true self is not your physical body but only use the body as a vehicle. You are not limited to this physical body. You are boundless. You are the master of the universe because you have God's essence within you. You are full of mercy and love because you share of God's spirit. Most people today have forgotten all these spiritual characteristics and do not know who they really are. Today you are regaining your conscience, your true self.
每个人活时灵性在他体内，若灵性已离开，他立刻就死亡。灵性附于天，而肉体由父母而来。因此，事实上我们已有道在身上，为何还要再寻求他，还要有点传师来传授？原因是我们已 不认识他了，我们以为肉体真我，而不知他原是假，因此我们变得自私，做了许多错事与罪恶。为了使此色身享受如此，使我们坠入轮回中，遭受无边痛苦。我们不知真正的我乃是灵性。 而我们已不是仅限于此肉身，我们是无限的广大，我们是宇宙之主宰，因我们的灵性与老是一体，我们的本性充满了慈悲与爱心，因我们是老之分灵。然而现在人们都失去了这些品性。 亦不知他究竟是谁。今天我们得到是的回真我良心。
Chapter 3 What are the three treasures? Today you have received the three treasures. A. The heavenly portal B. The divine mantra C. The symbolic seal A. The first treasure, the heavenly portal, the point where the teacher placed his finger upon your face during the ceremony, is called the heavenly portal. It is the abode of your true self and can be described in different ways, such as 1. Original nature. This is the true self, soul, or conscience which is eternal and indestructible. 2. The portal of birth and death. The heavenly portal is the door by which our original nature enters and leaves our body. Confucius asked, who can leave the house without using the door? Why do people not follow this way? 3. The way to heaven. A Buddhist sutra says, heaven is 108,000 miles away. These words are the metaphor which actually means that it was not easy to become enlightened because the true teacher was difficult to find and the Tao was not yet widely propagated. Without the proper understanding of the Tao, heaven seems very far away, but with a real understanding of the Tao, heaven is very near. Today your teacher has pointed out the way for you and you may now ascend to heaven with one step.
第三章，何谓三宝经天？你们所得之至宝，亦可称为三宝：一玄观，二口诀，三合同。以第一宝玄观，玄观玄妙莫测之门。玄观点传师向你们指点之处，它有许多名称，一点本性，此是我本来固有的真我灵性良心。它是不毁不灭的，它永远存在。二点生死之门户，玄观是灵性出入身体之门户。孔子曰，谁能出不由户，何莫由斯道也。三点通天大陆，佛经云，西天十万八千里，此是譬喻，亦成佛是不义之事，因为名师难访，大道还未普传。然而名师经已指点明明路，你一步登天。四点。
The main entrance. The heavenly portal is the main entrance. It is situated at the center and not to the left or right, above or below. This entrance was locked after your imperishable spirit entered the body at birth. If the heavenly portal is not unlocked by your teacher,your true self is not able to leave the body by the main entrance at the time of death. Instead, it will have to leave by one of the side gates, A. The eyes, B. The ears, C. The mouth, D. The nose, E. The navel, F. The vertex. If your spirit leaves from the ears, it is reborn as a viviparous animal, such as a horse, pig, cow, sheep, etc. B. Eyes, it is reborn as an oviparous bird. C. Mouth, it is reborn as a creature of the water, such as a fish, a lobster, etc. D. Nose, it is reborn as an insect, such as a fly, a moth, a bee,etc. E. Navel, it is reborn as an ordinary person. F. Vertex, it is reborn as a wealthy and powerful person. 4.
正门玄关是正门，它正好位于当中，不偏向左也不偏向右，不在上也不在下。当灵性投入身体后，四门关闭了。假如我们不遇名师指开玄关，临终时我们的灵性将无正门可出离身体，它只能由其他旁门出去，眼耳口鼻肚其顶门。如果灵性走旁门，亦由耳而出者，来生当为胎生之动物，如马、猪、牛、羊之类；二由眼而出者，来生 当为卵生之动物，如飞鸟之类。三，由口而出者，来生当为湿生之动物，如鱼虾之类。四，由鼻而出者，来生当为化生之动物，如苍蝇蜜蜂之类。五，由肚脐而出者，来生当为平庸之人。六，由丙门而出者，来生当为富贵之人。上述之路乃生死轮回之路，不能脱出生死之苦。点传师点开玄关正门，这是通天之路，我们不必再走四门，不必再坠入轮回受苦。但是我们必须要真修，否则玄关虽开，我们的灵性仍不能返天，因我们还是充满罪恶，灵性为罪恶所是不能自由从正门而出的。五点。
In the Bible, Matthew 14:11, John said to his disciples, I baptize you with water to show that you have repented, but that one who will come after me will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. The vow is transmitted to you in the temple of God through God as sanction and commandment. The holy lamp on the altar symbolizes God. In the transmittal ritual, the teacher uses the incense to lead a line of fire from the holy lamp to your heavenly portal. Then, using his finger, he connects God as spirit with your spirit so that they flow together as one, thereby enlightening you with God as spirit. This is the actual fulfillment of John's prophecy. 5.
圣经上记载，约翰对他的门徒说，我用水给你们施洗，表明你们已悔改。然而在我之后的将用圣灵与火给你们施洗。请记忆，你们是在上帝的宫殿里得到，因为我们有上帝的天命，那盏佛灯代表上帝老。在点道之仪式中，你们已见到点传师以香柱从佛灯引来一条筋指向你们的玄关，然后借点传师的手指点在你们的玄关之时，上帝一滴的圣灵已点开了你们的心窍，照破了黑暗。现在你们可见到约翰之预言已经实现在你们身上。6点。
Abhyamunibuddha said, I have the great Dharma which is hidden in the eyes. This indicates the location of the heavenly portal. 6.
释迦牟尼佛云，无有正法掩藏此语，暗示玄关之底。
Be the second treasure, the divine mantra 1. You have now been given the divine mantra. It is very important to remember it as it will save your life.It is only to be used in extremely dangerous situations. This mantra acts as a powerful spiritual distress signal to the divine forces, much like an SOS transmitted by radio waves. It is to be projected mentally and silently with great concentration while at the same time focusing the eyes on the heavenly portal and holding the symbolic seal with the hands. Powerful aid will immediately be sent to you in order to rescue you from danger. If you sincerely cultivate yourself, you will always remain under the refuge of Buddha.
二第二宝口诀心经或五字真经一刚才传授口诀给你们还记得吗请再说一遍当性命危险时你才用此宝将真经默念口中受报和同你将可被仙佛救护脱离危险不过要注意此口诀仅能于性命危急之时方可运用。假若我们真诚修道，当然我们将受天佛之庇佑。二点
The divine mantra which connects your true self with God. This mantra is without form, sound or color and is the essence of Tao.The underlying and ultimate principle of the universe. This mantra unites your being with that of the Tao forming a powerful bond. Every great religion indicates this potential unity, but they do not fully understand how to implement and effect it. You now have this knowledge and are familiar with its application.
二心经口传心受由声音而达入无声因果之真心由千经万典而达入真经真典心经心法真空也真我本性也三点
The true teaching is transmitted from mind to mind The true selfThe I, the spirit, the mind all indicate the true center of man or his real essence and original indestructible nature which is identical with Tao. The human being is a microcosm, sharing all the attributes of the macrocosm. Since he is essentially divine,Man only needs to understand the nature of reality and align himself with it. The more pure and refined his nature, the more conscious he becomes of his relationship with the Tao. When he realizes that he is one with the Tao, he has become fully enlightened.
三以心传心口传心手以老之心传于众生之真心此者老的分灵之心也
See The third treasure the symbolic seal one In Chinese Ka means to combine and Tun means altogetherThe symbolic seal which is formed by the two hands joined together is the golden seal which is formed by the two hands joined together is the golden seal which unites us with God. It is like a contract or mutual agreement which is the actual meaning of Hatun between you and your heavenly mother. It acts as a signal, password,or passport. It is a spiritual instrument of identification, as well as symbol with many ramifications. 2. When you hold the symbolic seal you are united with God. 3. The left hand is good so it is placed on the outside, covering the right hand.The right hand is often used for evil purposes, such as beating and killing. The right hand is placed on the inside because of its evil propensities and is shielded by the left hand. Together the hands hold the word child which is formed by the two thumbs in proximity symbolizing the Chinese word hai which means child. This hand symbol acts as a direct signal to God. It serves to mobilize heavenly protection and causes the user to escape from any impending calamity. 4. Let us quote some words from the Bible, Matthew 19:13-15. Some people brought children to Jesus for him to place his hands on and to pray for them, but the disciples scolded the people. Jesus said, "Let the children come to me and do not stop them, because the kingdom of heaven belongs to them." He placed his hands on them and then went away. This event illustrates the power and significance of the symbolic seal. At that time Jesus placed his hands on the children's heads and explained that this is the way to God's kingdom. Today we hold the child symbol and realize that we are the children of God and are willing to return to God's presence.
3. 第三，饱和同一点和同之意，和是和成一体。 同是相同，合同象征老四与我们的精印，表示我们已归根人。我们手抱合同，表示我们要与老合成一体，同老一样，是说与老和灵永不再分开。2. 点和合同，同同和。 抱起合同，能闭眼罗。3. 点左手数扇当在外，右手数鳄鱼那边。此外，向下怀中抱，能脱酒大大节冠。4. 现在让我们应用圣经之语句，有一些人带孩子们到耶稣跟前求耶稣为他们按手祝福，但是使徒们责备那些人。耶稣说：“让孩子们到我这里来，不要阻止他们，因为上帝的国是属于如此的人。”耶稣为他们按手祝福，然后离开。 从这件事，我们可以了解，它是对合同之一种预言。在那时，耶稣把手按在孩子头上，并说：“须如此方能返回天国。”如今我们手抱子凯旋，并觉悟我们是上帝的儿女，且愿意回返上帝身边。
Chapter 4. Why do the introducer and the sponsor take an oath at the altar before you receive the bow from your teacher? Two persons take an oath at the altar, one as your introducer and one as your sponsor. Without these two persons, the bow will not be transmitted to you. The introducer vouches for your character and guarantees your good conduct. The sponsor guarantees that the bow is the true path and that the teachings are genuine. A bow is also taken to guarantee that any money which you may donate to the temple will only be used for the printing of books and other such noble purposes.
第四章，为什么引宝要立愿在点师还未传道给你之前，有两个人做你的引宝师先立愿引宝你求道，否则点传师不可传道给你。这两人保证你是好人，并发誓他们是引你入正道。 并非左道旁门或斜角，他们并非狂哄你的钱财，否则他们愿受天雷诛。你奉献的功德经是来见佛堂，引善书。 任何人也不能把它用在私人用途上。
Chapter 5 Why I Should Take an Oath Before Receiving the Dao. Before anyone receives the Dao, he has to take a vow which states that he will faithfully adhere to the principles of Dao and will not reveal the secret teachings of the three treasures to anybody.
第五章，为什么要力求道？愿每个人在为求道前必须先立愿，表白他将诚心报道及不泄露天机三宝给任何人。
Chapter 6 How to Save Human Beings. Now you have received the Dao which is ineffable, sacred and sublime. You have just been saved by someone, so now you should try your best to spread these exalted teachings to your fellow human beings and urge your family, friends and acquaintances to receive the Dao. This is of great merit for you because you are not only saving someone's physical body from disaster, but you are also saving his true self from the sufferings of reincarnation. Also, you not only save that one person because, if he cultivates himself properly, he can also save seven generations of his offspring by his virtue. How great is your merit!
第六章，如何救度众生。如今你已得了大道至宝，你已被人救度，你也应该去救度别人。所以请你尽量的度你家人亲戚朋友求道，让他们亦得蒙上天之恩典，此乃你莫大之功德。因为你不仅救了他的灵性脱离轮回之苦，并且救他的色身脱离劫难。同时你不仅是救了一人，假若他真修，他将能以他的功德来超拔九玄七祖。你的功德何其大呀！
你应该是太平心思。
Equandao's objectives. Equandao is the very quintessence of the 5,000 years of Chinese history. Equandao is preached for the objectives as follows: worship the heaven and earth, salute to the god, be patriotic to the country and devoted to duties, be appropriately behaved and courteous, respect parents in filial piety as well as teachers, trust friends and neighbors, rectify our sins toward righteousness, honor 5 ethics and 8 morals, elucidate sagacious doctrines, faithfully observe guiding rules, clarify our mind and purify ourselves out of worry, restore to our very nature, enlighten our intuitive ability and conscience, regulate ourselves and others alike, enlighten ourselves and well-being for the entire world. Copied from Equandao's Association.
道之宗旨，天地礼身于，爱国忠志敦信，崇礼孝父母，重知尊信朋友，和乡邻改恶相，善讲明五伦八，德阐发五教，圣人之傲止克，尊父为纲常之，古礼喜心迪利，戒假修真恢复本性之自然，启发良知良能之至善己利利人，己达达人完，世界为清平化，人心未良善济，世界未大同。
66条经典禅语：侠客文章。1点，人之所以痛苦，在于追求错误的东西；2点，如果你不给自己烦恼，别人也永远不可能给你烦恼，因为你自己的内心你放不下；3点，你永远要感谢给你逆境的众生。 4点，你永远要宽恕众生，不论他有多坏，甚至他伤害过你，你一定要放下，才能得到真正的快乐。5点，当你快乐时，你要想，这快乐不是永恒的；当你痛苦时，你要想，这痛苦也不是永恒。 6点，今日的执着会造成明日的后悔。7点，你可以拥有爱，但不要执着，因为分离是必然的。8点，不要浪费你的生命在你一定会后悔的地方上。9点，你识魔时候放下，识魔时候就没有烦恼。 10点，每一种创伤都是一种成熟。11点，狂妄的人有救，自卑的人没有救。认识自己，降服自己，改变自己，才能改变别人。12点，你不要一直不满人家，你应该一直检讨自己才对。
不满人家，是苦了你自己。13点，一个人如果不能从内心去原谅别人，那他就永远不会心安理得。14点，心中装满着自己的看法与想法的人，永远听不见别人的心声。15点，毁灭人只要一句话。
培植一个人却要千句话，请你多口下留情。16点，根本不必回头去看咒骂你的人是谁。如果有一条疯狗咬你一口，难道你也要趴下去反咬他一口吗？17点，永远不要浪费你的1分1秒。 去想任何你不喜欢的人。18点，请你用慈悲心和温和的态度，把你的不满与委屈说出来，别人就容易接受。19点，同样的瓶子，你为什么要装毒药呢？同样的心理，你为什么要充满着烦恼呢？ 20点，得不到的东西，我们会一直以为它是美好的。 那是因为你对他了解太少，没有时间与他相处在一起。当有一天你深入了解后，你会发现原不是你想象中的那么美好。二十一点活着一天，就是有福气，就该珍惜。当我哭泣我没有鞋子穿的时候，我发现有人却没有脚。二十二点多一分心力去注意别人，就少一分心力反省自己，你懂吗？二十三点憎恨别人对自己是一种很大的损失。二十四点每一个人都拥有生命，但并非每个人都懂得生命，乃至于珍惜生命。不了解生命的人，生命对他来说是一种惩罚。二十五点情执是苦恼的原因，放下情执你才能得到自在。二十六点不要太肯定自己的看法，这样子比较少后悔。二十七点当你对自己诚实的时候，世界上没有人能够欺骗得了你。二十八点用伤害别人的手段来掩饰自己缺点的人是可耻的。二十九点默默的关怀与祝福别人，那是一种无形的布施。三十点不要刻意去猜测他人的想法，如果你没有智慧与经验的正确判断，通常都会有错误的。三十一点要了解一个人，只需要看他的出发点与目的的是否相同，就可以知道他是否真心的。三十二点人生的真理，只是藏在平淡无味之中。三十三点不洗澡的人，应擦香水是不会香的。名声与尊贵是来自于真才实学的，有德自然香。原谅别人就是给自己心中留下空间，以便回旋。三十四点时间总会过去的，让时间流走你的烦恼吧。三十五点你硬要把单纯的事情看得很严重，那样子你会很痛苦。三十六点永远扭曲别人善意的人，无药可救。三十七点说一句谎话，要编造十句谎话来弥补，何苦呢？三十八点白白的过一天，无所事事，就像犯了窃盗罪一样。三十九点广结众缘，就是不要去伤害任何一个人。四十点沉默是毁谤最好的答复。四十一点对人恭敬，就是在庄严你自己。四十二点拥有一颗无私的爱心，便拥有了一切。四十三点来是偶然的，走是必然的，所以你必须随缘不变，不变随缘。四十四点慈悲是你最好的武器。四十五点只要面对现实，你才能超越现实。四十六点良心是每一个人最公正的审判官，你骗得了别人，却永远骗不了你自己的良心。四十七点不懂得自爱的人，是没有能力去爱别人的。四十八点有时候我们要冷静问问自己，我们在追求什么？ 我们活着为了什么。49点，不要因为小小的争执远离了你至亲的好友，也不要因为小小的怨恨忘记了别人的大恩。50点，感谢上苍我所拥有的，感谢上苍我所没有的。51点，凡事能站在别人的角度为他人着想，这个就是慈悲。52点，说话不要有攻击性，不要有杀伤力，不夸己能，不扬人恶，自然能化敌为友。53点，诚实的面对你内心的矛盾和污点，不要欺骗你自己。54点，因果不曾亏欠过我们什么，所以请不要抱怨。55点，大多数的人一辈子只做了三件事，自欺欺人被人欺。56点，信是最大的骗子，别人能骗你一时，而他却会骗你一辈子。57点，只要自觉心安，东西南北都好，如有一人未度，切莫自己逃了。58点，当你手中抓住一件东西不放时，你只能拥有这件东西，如果你肯放手，你就有机会选择别的。人的心若死执自己的观念，不肯放下，那么他的智慧也只能达到某种程度而已。59点，如果你能够平平安安地度过一天，那就是一种福气了。多少人在今天已经见不到明天的太阳，多少人在今天已经成了残废，多少人在今天已经失去了自由，多少人在今天已经家破人亡。60点，你有你的生命观，我有我的生命观，我不干涉你，只要我能我就感化你，如果不能，那我就认命。61点，你希望掌握永恒，那你必须控制现在。62点，恶口永远不要出自于我们的口中，不管它有多坏，有多恶，你欲骂它，你的心就被污染了。你要想，他就是你的善知识。63点，别人可以违背因果，别人可以害我们、打我们、毁谤我们，可是我们不能因此而憎恨别人。为什么？我们一定要保有一颗完整的本性和一颗清净的心。64点，如果一个人没有苦难的感受，就不容易对他人给予同情。你要学救苦救难的精神，就得先受苦受难。65点，世界原本就不是属于你，因此你用不着抛弃，要抛弃的是一切的执着。万物皆为我所用，但非我所属。66点，虽然我们不能改变周遭的世界，我们就只好改变自己，用慈悲心和智慧心来面对这一切。
士比亚的名言佳句。莎士比亚名言录点
html://mengren/mequals%e8%ab%ab%e5%a3%ab%e6%af%94%e4%ba%90%。
与其做愚蠢的智人，不如做聪明的愚人。莎士比亚谦逊是最高的客气功夫。莎士比亚口头的推测不过是一些悬空的希望，实际的行动才能够产生决定的结果。莎士比亚爱情，它会随着全身的血液像思想一般迅速通过了五官四肢，使每一个器官发挥双倍的效能。它使眼睛增加一重明亮，恋人眼中的光芒可以使猛鹰炫目，恋人的耳朵听得出最微细的声音，任何鬼祟的奸谋都逃不过他的知觉。恋人的感觉比袋和瓜牛的触角还要微妙灵敏，恋人的舌头是善于变味的巴丘斯希腊酒神，显得迟钝。莎士比亚一个面具套不下所有人的脸。莎士比亚，你自己和你所有的一切，倘不拿出来贡献于人世，仅仅一个人独善其身，那实在是一种浪费。莎士比亚最后的结果确定工作的成败。莎士比亚智慧是命运的一部分，一个人所遭遇的外界环境是会影响他的头脑的。莎士比亚，我们做的坏事往往因为正好迎合下等人的口味，就被他们高声夸奖，说成是我们办的好事。莎士比亚志向不过是记忆的努力，生气勃勃地降生，但却很难成长。莎士比亚，我们的身体就像一座园圃，我们的意志是这园圃的园丁。莎士比亚出门看天气，上是问行情。莎士比亚，春光不自留，莫怪东风恶。莎士比亚，女人，你的名字是弱者。莎士比亚，自愿的贫困胜于不定的浮华，穷奢极欲的人要是贪得无厌，比最贫困的而知足的人更是不幸的多了。莎士比亚无言的淳朴所表示的情感才是最丰富的。莎士比亚无言的淳朴所表示的情感才是最丰富的。莎士比亚真正勇敢的人应当能够智慧地忍受最难堪的荣辱，不以身外的荣辱介怀，用其是宁忍的态度避免无谓的横阔。莎士比亚多听少说，接受每一个人的责难，但是保留你的最后裁决。莎士比亚点燃了的火炬不是为了火炬本身，就像我们的美德应该超过自己照亮别人，否则等于没用。莎士比亚，友谊在别的事情上 都是可靠的，在恋爱的事情上却不能信托，所以恋人们都是用他自己的唇舌，谁生着，让他自己去传达情愫吧，总不要请别人代劳。因为美貌是一个女巫，在她的魔力之下，忠诚是会在热情里溶解的。莎士比亚世间的任何事物，追求时候的兴致总要比享用时候的兴致浓烈。一艘新下水的船只扬帆出港的当儿，多么像一个娇小的少年给那轻狂的风儿爱抚搂抱，可是等到他回来的时候，船身已遭风日的侵蚀，船帆也变成了百节的破烂。他有多么像一个落魄的浪子，给那轻狂的风儿肆意欺凌。莎士比亚真理是永远蒙蔽不了的。莎士比亚一个本领超群的人，必须在一群劲敌之前成，才能够写出他的不同凡俗的身手。莎士比亚品性是一个人的内在，名誉是一个的外貌。莎士比亚世界上有一种人，他们的脸上装出一副心如止水的神气，故意表示他们的冷静，好让人家称赞他们一生智慧深沉，思想渊博。他们的神气之间好像说，我的说话都是纶音天语，我要是一张开嘴唇来，不许有一头狗乱叫。我看透这一种人，他们只是因为不说话博得了智慧的名声，可是我可以确定说一句，要是他们说起话来，听见的人谁都会骂他们是傻瓜的。莎士比亚每一个被束缚的奴隶都可以凭着他自己的手挣脱他的锁链，莎士比亚凭着日归上前思的阴影，你也能知道时间在偷偷地走向亘古。莎士比亚草率的婚姻少美满，莎士比亚苦难可以试验一个人的品格，非常的遭遇可以显出非常的气节。莎士比亚本来无望的事，大胆尝试往往能成功。莎士比亚思想是生命的奴隶，生命是时间的弄人。莎士比亚庄严的大海产生蛟龙和鲸鲵，清浅的小河里只有一些供顶足美味的鱼虾。莎士比亚品性是一个人的内在，名誉是一个人的外貌。莎士比亚一个使性子的女人，就像翻腾的浊水，纵使口干舌燥也不愿啜饮一口。莎士比亚真实爱情的途径并不平坦，莎士比亚无论男人女人，名誉是他们灵魂里面最切身的珍宝。谁偷窃我的钱囊，不过偷窃到一些废物，一些虚无的幻值，他从我的手里转到他的手里，他也会做过千万人的奴隶。可是谁偷了我的名誉去，那么他 虽然并不因此而不足，我却因为失去它而成为赤贫了。莎士比亚，不要污蔑你所不知道的真理，否则你将以生命的危险重重补偿你的过去。莎士比亚仅仅一个人独善其身，那实在是一种浪费。上天生下我们，是要把我们当作火炬，不是照亮自己，而是普照世界。因为我们的德行倘不能推及他人，那就等于没有一样。莎士比亚书籍是全人类的营养品，莎士比亚爱情的鲜艳的容色和热烈的心，也会因困苦而起了变化。莎士比亚最恶劣的事态总有一天告一段落，或者逐渐恢复原状。莎士比亚生活里没有书籍，就好像没有阳光；智慧里没有书籍，就好像鸟儿没有翅膀。莎士比亚爱情里面要是掺杂了和他本身无关的算计，那就不是真的爱情。莎士比亚宁愿做一朵篱下的野花，不愿做一朵受恩惠的蔷薇。与其逢迎献美，偷取别人的欢心，无名被众人所鄙弃。莎士比亚任何恶德的外表也都附着若干美德的标志。莎士比亚爱的力量是和平，从不顾理性成规和荣辱，它能使一切恐惧、震惊和痛苦在伸手时化作甜蜜。莎士比亚不如意的婚姻好比是座地狱，一辈子鸡争鹅斗不得安生，相反的，选到一个称心如意的配偶，就能百年协和，幸福无穷。莎士比亚对人要和气，可是不要过分狭隘。莎士比亚如果一年到头如假日，岂不像连日工作那样疲乏？莎士比亚若是一个人的思想不能比飞鸟上升的更高，那就是一种卑微不足道的思想。莎士比亚，无论一个人的天赋如何优异，外表或内心如何美好，也必须在他的德性的光辉照耀到他人身上发生了热力，再有感受他的热力的人把那热力反射到自己身上的时候，才能体会到他本身的价值。莎士比亚富贵固然和友谊的好坏无关，但是贫穷却最能考验朋友增爱分明的真假。莎士比亚不速之客是在告辞以后才最受欢迎。莎士比亚无言的纯洁的天真，往往比说话更能打动人心。莎士比亚与其做愚蠢的聪明人，不如做聪明的愚人。莎士比亚闪光的东西并不都是金子，动听的语言并不都是豪华。莎士比亚华夏再富丽堂皇，也只是坟上楼阁。莎士比亚明智的人绝不坐下来为失败而哀嚎， 他们一定乐观地寻找办法来加以以管。就莎士比亚，道德和才艺是远胜于富贵的资产。堕落的子孙可以把危险的门第败坏，把巨富的财产荡毁，可是道德和才艺却可以使一个凡人成为不配的神明。莎士比亚黑夜使眼睛失去它的作用，但却使耳朵的听觉更为灵敏。它虽然妨碍了视觉的活动，却给予了听觉加倍的补偿。莎士比亚自有戏剧以来，他的目的始终是反莎士比亚，充实思想不在于言语的复利。莎士比亚在时间的大钟上只有两个字，现在。莎士比亚简洁是智慧的灵魂，冗长是肤浅的早逝。莎士比亚千万人的失败都有是失败在做事不彻底，往往做到离成功上差一步就终止不做了。莎士比亚情欲犹如炭火，必须使它冷却，否则那烈火会把心儿烧焦。莎士比亚对自己不信任，还会信任什么真理？莎士比亚心中充满旋律，能渗透到人们的心灵。莎士比亚，我的言语高高飞起，我的思想滞留地下。没有思想的言语永远不会上升天界。莎士比亚美貌和智慧很少结合在一起。莎士比亚让我指点20个人做人的道理，倒还容易，可是要我做这20个人中间的一个，奉行自己的教训，就没那么简单啦。莎士比亚不要想到什么就说什么，凡事必须三思而行。莎士比亚道德和才艺是远胜于富贵的资产，堕落的子孙可以把危险的门第败坏，把巨富的财产荡毁，而道德和才艺却可以使一个凡人成为不朽的神明。莎士比亚人若神经紧张，说东道西，就会犹豫不定，反把事情耽误了。耽误的结果是叫人丧志气连，寸步难移。莎士比亚对人要和气，但不要狭腻。莎士比亚起先的冷淡将会使以后的恋爱更加热烈。莎士比亚如果要别人成醒，首先要自己成醒。莎士比亚当命运突然改变了心肠，把他的宠儿一脚踢下山坡的时候，那些攀龙附凤之徒本也跟在他后面匍匐披行的，这时候便冷眼看他跌落，没有一个人做他患难中的同伴。莎士比亚才忍藏着锋利的牙齿。莎士比亚终成因为努力的狂妄而变得毫无价值。莎士比亚人生就像是一匹用善恶的丝线交错成的布，我们的善行必须受我们过去过失的鞭挞，才不会过分趾高气扬。我们的罪恶又赖我们的善行把它们掩盖， 才不会完全绝望。莎士比亚，我可以教训20个人，吩咐他们应该做些什么，做这20个人中间的一个。履行我自己的教训，我就要敬谢过敏了。莎士比亚书籍是全世界的营养品，生活里没有书籍，就好像没有阳光；智慧里没有书籍，就好像鸟儿没有翅膀。莎士比亚装傻的好也是要靠才情的，他必须窥伺被他所取笑的人们的心情，了解他们的身份，还得看准了时机，然后像窥伺田眼前每一只鸟雀的野鹰一样，每个机会都不放松。这是一种和聪明人的艺术一样艰难的工作。莎士比亚，一切朋友都要得到他们忠贞的报酬，一切仇敌都要尝到他们罪恶的苦悲。莎士比亚没有德性的美貌，是转瞬即逝的，可是因为在你的美貌之中有一颗美好的灵魂，所以你的美貌是永存的。莎士比亚，万事总需守权力派，不能再问良心。莎士比亚，爱和叹相同，烧起来的没法叫它冷却。莎士比亚，一套衣服一顶帽子的是让时髦不时髦，对于一个人本来是没有什么相干的。莎士比亚只需一阵烈风就能把乌云吹散，并不是每块乌云都能引起一场风暴。莎士比亚失去了诚信，就等同于敌人毁灭了自己。莎士比亚，我荒废了时间，时间便把我荒废了。莎士比亚，爱情是叹息吹起的一阵烟，恋人的眼中有他进化了的火星，恋人的眼泪是他激起的波涛，他又是最智慧的疯狂，更喉的苦味，吃不到嘴的蜜糖。莎士比亚，青春是块原料，迟早要制作成型。莎士比亚，青春的特征乃是动不动就要背叛自己，即使身旁没有诱惑的力量。莎士比亚，若有汗烟，其实岂知莎士比亚一个骄傲的人，结果总是在骄傲里毁灭了自己。莎士比亚，人的一生是短的，但如果卑劣抵过这短短的一生，就太长了。莎士比亚，您的花言巧语对于了解您的人来说是足以泄露您的空虚和弱点。莎士比亚，人在不走运的时候总是摆出一副老。莎士比亚，爱情不过是一种风。莎士比亚，报复不是勇敢，忍受才是勇敢。莎士比亚，自古红颜多薄命。莎士比亚，人类是一件多么了不起的杰作，多么高贵的灵性，多么伟大的力量，多么优美的仪表，多么文雅的举动，在行为上多么像一个天使， 在智慧上多么像一个天神，宇宙的精华，万物的灵，长莎士比亚漂亮的阐发，给俊俏的脸蛋平添光彩。莎士比亚直到再找不到对手才收藏起自己的剑锋。莎士比亚人生苦短，若虚度年华，则短暂的人生就太长了。莎士比亚酒池上得来的朋友，等到酒尽樽空，转眼成为路人。莎士比亚时间老人自己是个秃顶，所以直到世界末日也会有大群秃顶的徒子徒孙。莎士比亚爱情不是花印下的甜言，不是桃花源中的蜜语，不是青年的眼泪，更不是死硬的强迫。爱情是建立在共同语言的基础上的。莎士比亚天色越是晴朗空明，越显得浮云的浑浊。莎士比亚名字有什么关系？把玫瑰花叫做别的名称，他还是照样芳香。莎士比亚书籍是人类知识的总结。莎士比亚音乐有一种魅力，可以感化人心向善，也可以诱人走上堕落之路。莎士比亚谁想要马高山夷为平地？当一座山推倒以后，另一座山又已经堆了起来。莎士比亚毒药有时也能治病。莎士比亚从各方面对习俗的质疑，是每一个莎士比亚爱是一种甜蜜的痛苦。真诚的爱情永不是走一条平坦的道路的。莎士比亚没有力量的意志，就如同假装士兵的莎士比亚，生命的短促，只有美德能将它流传到遥远的后世。莎士比亚时间正像一个趋炎附势的主人，对于一个临去的客人，不过和他略微握握手。对于一个新来的客人，却伸开了两臂，飞也似的过去抱住他。欢迎是永远含笑的，告别总是带着叹息。莎士比亚不应当急于求成，应当去熟悉自己的研究对象，锲而不舍，时间会成全一切。凡事开始最难，然而更难的是何以善终。莎士比亚大海有涯岸，热烈的爱却没有边界。莎士比亚，我们宁愿重用一个活跃的侏儒，不要一个贪睡的巨人。莎士比亚书籍是人类知识的总统。莎士比亚爱和叹相同，烧起来的没法叫它冷却。莎士比亚，假如我必须死，我会把黑暗当作新娘，把它拥抱在我的怀里。莎士比亚没有比正直更富的遗产。莎士比亚血液中的火焰已燃烧起来，最坚强的誓言也就等于草杆。莎士比亚书籍是全世界的营养品，生活里没有书籍就好像没有阳光，智慧里没有书籍就好像鸟儿没有翅膀。 莎士比亚白糖上面浇蜂蜜，蜂蜜上面盖白糖，莎士比亚心灵的伟大表现的并不明显，因为莎士比亚庙套虽大无精等，平陀虽小压千金，莎士比亚有德的妇人，即使容貌丑陋，也是家庭的装饰。莎士比亚书籍是全世界的营养品，生活里没有书籍，就好像没有阳光，智慧里没有书籍，就好像鸟儿没有翅膀。莎士比亚演戏的好像总是那三个人丈夫，莎士比亚竟有爱早还是爱竹敬天。莎士比亚勇气是在磨练中生长的，莎士比亚爱和炭相同，烧起来得设法叫它冷却，让它任意着，那它就要把一颗心烧焦。莎士比亚理智可以制定法律来约束感情，可是热情激动起来，就会把冷酷的法令灭弃不顾。年轻人是一头不受拘束的野兔，会跳过老年人所设立的理智的樊篱。莎士比亚，你要看见朋友之间用的这不自然的礼貌的时候，就可以知道他们的感情已经衰落。莎士比亚生命短促，只有美德能将它流传到辽远的后世。莎士比亚不要指着月亮起誓，它是变化无常的，每个月都盈亏圆缺。你要是指着它起誓，也许你的爱情也像它一样的无常。莎士比亚最深刻的真理是最简单和最朴素。莎士比亚，朋友间必须患难相济，那才能说得上是真正的友谊。莎士比亚人世间的贺光荣往往产生在罪恶之中，为了身外的浮名牺牲自己的良心。莎士比亚真正的爱情是不能用言语表达的，行为才是忠心的最好说明。莎士比亚正像太阳会从乌云中探出头来一样，不依粗浮，可以格外显出一个人的正直。莎士比亚，谁告诉我真话，即使他的话里藏着死亡，我也会像听人家恭维我一样听着他。莎士比亚一切礼仪都是为了文饰，那些虚应不是的行为，言不由衷的欢迎，出尔反尔的殷勤而设立的。如果有真实的友谊，这些虚伪的形式就该一律摒弃。莎士比亚，我承认天底下再没有比爱情的责罚更痛苦的，也没有比服侍他更快乐的事了。莎士比亚，宅门八字朝南开，有礼无钱莫进来。莎士比亚忠诚的爱情充溢在我的心里，我无法估计自己享有的财富。莎士比亚，时间会刺破青春的华丽精致，会把平行线刻上美人的额角， 会吃掉稀世珍宝，天生丽质，什么都逃不过他横扫的镰刀。莎士比亚英雄失时把头低，凤凰落甲不如击。莎士比亚任何一种兴趣都包含着天性中有轻莎士比亚有力的理由造成有力的行动。莎士比亚不太热烈的爱情才会维持久远。莎士比亚抛弃时间的人，时间抛弃他。莎士比亚在紧张的行动中间言语不过是一口冷气。莎士比亚良心无非是懦夫们所用的一个名词，他们害怕强有力者，借他来做旁塞。莎士比亚洪水可以从涓滴的细流中发生，莎士比亚爱情里要是掺杂了和他本身无关的算计，那就不是真的爱情。莎士比亚淳朴和忠诚所呈现的礼物总是可取的。莎士比亚有德必有勇，正直的人绝不胆怯。莎士比亚行为无价宝，甚为护身术。莎士比亚有德必有勇，正直的人绝不胆怯。莎士比亚为剑往往是非野心的阶梯，凭借着他一步步爬上了高处。当他一旦登上了最高的一级之后，他便不再回顾那梯子，他的眼光才夺目仰望云霄，瞧不起他从前所视为凭借的低下的阶梯。莎士比亚最理想的境地既不可达，人往往不知退而求其次。莎士比亚和狐狸打交道，你必须比他更有心。莎士比亚生平富足的盛世突然养成一批懦夫，困苦永远是坚强之母。莎士比亚强有力的理由产生强有力的行动。莎士比亚熄灭吧，熄灭吧，瞬间的灯火。人生只不过是行走着的影子。莎士比亚要是在我们的生命之中，理智和情欲不能保持平衡，我们血肉的邪心就会引导我们到一个荒唐的结局。可是我们有的是理智，可以冲淡我们汹涌的热情肉体的刺激和奔放的淫欲。莎士比亚虽然全世是一头不直的熊，可是金子可以拉着他的鼻子走。莎士比亚好酒无需招牌，莎士比亚有很多良友，剩余有很多财富。莎士比亚无数人世的变化孕育在时间的胚胎里。莎士比亚老实人从来不吃亏，莎士比亚为的之前是请求，记得之后是命令。莎士比亚爱情的野心使人备受痛苦。莎士比亚酒池上得来的朋友，等到酒尽樽空，转眼成为路人。一片冬天的乌云刚刚出现，这二飞虫们早就躲得不知去向了。莎士比亚不管饕餮的时间怎样吞噬这一切，我们要在这一席尚存的时候 努力博取我们的声誉，使时间的镰刀不能伤害我们。莎士比亚不良的习惯会随时阻碍你走向成名、获利和享乐的路上去。莎士比亚傻瓜的迟钝是才子的磨刀，使莎士比亚我们一个指头痛疼的时候，全身都会觉得难受。莎士比亚善恶的区别在于行为的本身，不在于地位的有无。莎士比亚金钱是个好兵士，有了它就可以使人勇气百倍。莎士比亚愚人的蠢事算不得稀奇，聪明人的蠢事才叫人笑痛肚皮。因为他用全副的本领证明了自己的愚笨。莎士比亚诡计需要伪装，真理喜欢阳光。莎士比亚爱比杀人重罪更难隐藏。爱情的黑夜有中午的阳光，莎士比亚爱你自己要爱在最后，真爱那些恨你的人。诚实比起腐败会给你赢得略多的好处，在你的右手里永远举着温顺的和平之，免得嫉妒之徒说闲话。做人要公正，不要怕，你所要达到的一切目的应该是你的国家、上帝和真理所要达到的目的。莎士比亚谣言会把人们所恐惧的敌方军力增加一倍，正向回声会把一句话化成两句话一样。莎士比亚轻浮和虚荣是一个不知足的贪食者，他在吞噬一切之后，结果必然牺牲在自己的贪欲之下。莎士比亚老实人就是傻瓜，虽然一片好心，莎士比亚谣言是一只凭着推测、猜疑和臆度吹响的笛子。莎士比亚简洁是智慧的灵魂，冗长是肤浅的凿，是莎士比亚为失策找理由，反而是该失策更明显。莎士比亚袭起那个怪物，虽然是魔鬼，会昏掉一切的羞耻心，也会做天使，把日积月累的美德善行熏陶成自然而然而令人安之若素的家常便饭。莎士比亚没有比正直更富的遗产。莎士比亚同一的太阳照着他的宫殿，也不曾比了我们的草屋。日光是一视同仁的，莎士比亚诚实比起腐败会给你赢得更多的好处。莎士比亚爱情不过是一种风，莎士比亚一个骄傲的人，结果总是在骄傲中毁灭了自己。莎士比亚爱是一种甜蜜的痛苦。莎士比亚任何大人物的章事，无论是国王的冠冕、摄政的宝剑、大将的琼标，或是法官的礼服，都比不上仁慈那样更能衬托出他们的庄严高贵。莎士比亚什么地位、什么面子，多少愚人为了你这虚伪的外表而领。然而，生为莎士比亚，老实说， 必就有许多大人物，尽管口头上拼命讨好平民，心里却一点也不喜欢他们。莎士比亚，一个人无论有着什么奇才异能，当然不把那种才能传达别人的身上，他就等于一无所有。也只有在把才能发展出去以后所博得的赞美声中，才可以认识它本身的价值。莎士比亚，爱的力量是和平，从不顾理性成规和荣辱，它能使一切恐惧、震惊和痛苦在身受时化作甜蜜。莎士比亚没有什么事是好的或坏的，但思想却使其中有所不同。莎士比亚人生就像于短重复叙述的故事一般，可见莎士比亚有些人对你恭维不离口，可全都不是患难朋友。莎士比亚被认为是诚实的人都会感到心里有莎士比亚，你的舌头就像一匹快马，他奔得太快，会把力气都奔完了。莎士比亚放弃时间的人，时间也放弃他。莎士比亚命运如娼妓，听见遭遗弃。莎士比亚爱情里面要是掺杂了和他本身无关的算计，那就不是真的爱情。莎士比亚生命在发展中得到延长，因为思想莎士比亚两个人骑一匹马，总有一个人在后面。莎士比亚要是不能把握时机，就要终身蹭蹭一事无成。莎士比亚传播思想，无损于思想的传播者。莎士比亚，我们所要做的事，应该一想到就做，因为人的想法是会变化的，有多少舌头，多少手，多少意外，就会有多少忧郁，多少迟延。莎士比亚，你写诗句和他交换着爱情的纪念物，在月夜他的窗前，你用做作的声调唱着假作多情的诗篇，你用头发编成的外环指节，虚华的事物，琐碎的玩具、花束、糖果，这些可以强烈地骗有一个稚嫩的少女之心的性质来偷得她的情。你用诡计盗取了她的心。莎士比亚，我们粗心的错误，往往不知看重我们自己所有的可贵的事物，直至丧失了他们以后，方使认识他们的真假。我们的无理的增嫌，往往伤害了我们的朋友，然后再在他们的坟墓之前追凶哀泣。莎士比亚，浪子挥霍的是他的祖业。财迷葬送莎士比亚，虽然权力是一头不值的熊，可是金子可以拉着他的鼻子走。莎士比亚仅仅一个人独善其身，那实在是一种浪费。上天升上我们，是要把我们当作火炬，不是照亮自己，而是普照世界。因为我们的德行尚不能推及他人，那就等于没有一样。 莎士比亚无瑕的名誉是世间最纯粹的珍珠。莎士比亚真正的爱情是不能用言语表达的，行为才是忠心的最好说明。莎士比亚无数人的失败都是失败于做事情不彻底，往往做到一成功只差一步就停下来。莎士比亚，女人是用耳朵恋爱的，而男人如果会产生爱情的话，却是用眼睛来恋爱。莎士比亚，时间是审查一切罪犯的最老练的法官。莎士比亚俏皮话就像练剑用的钝刀猴子，怎样使也伤不了人。莎士比亚朋友间必须是患难相济，那才能说得上是真正的友谊。莎士比亚志愿不过是记忆的努力，总是有始无终，虎头蛇尾，像未熟些果子密布树梢，一朝红烂就会离去枝条。莎士比亚一个人看不见自己的鼻子，教堂屋顶上的风景标变幻莫测。莎士比亚适当的悲衰可以表示感情的深切，过度的伤心却可以证明智慧的欠缺。莎士比亚恶人的友谊一下子就会变成恐惧，恐惧会引起彼此憎恨，憎恨的结果总有一方或双方得到就有应得的死亡或祸根。莎士比亚谦虚是最高的克己功夫。莎士比亚欺人的希望是一个命人，一个时刻当死神将要温柔地替人解除生命的羁绊的时候，虚伪的希望却拉住他的手，使人在困苦之中苟延残喘。莎士比亚尤其是小孩子的工作，莎士比亚社会建筑在实力上头，所以实力变莎士比亚有些人对你恭维不离口，可全都不是患难朋友。莎士比亚一个人思虑太多就会失去做人的乐趣。莎士比亚爱比杀人重罪更难隐藏，爱情的黑夜有中午的阳光，莎士比亚必有忍，春乃有己，有容得乃大。莎士比亚一个人无论有着什么奇才异能，当然不把那种才能传达到别人的身上，他就等于一无所有。莎士比亚皇上就跟我一样，也是一个人罢了。一朵紫罗兰花而他闻起来，跟我闻起来还不是一样。他头上和我头上和顶着一方天，他也不过用眼睛来看，耳朵来听啊。把一切容钱丢开，还他一个赤裸裸的本相，那么他只是一个人罢了。虽说他的心思寄托在比我们高出一层的事物上，可是好比一只在云霄里飞翔的老鹰，它有时也不免降落下来，栖息在枝头或地面上。莎士比亚，如果我们生命的天平上 一边没有理智的平衡平衡，另一边情欲的平衡，那么我们身上下流的欲念就会把我们引导到荒唐透顶的结局。莎士比亚不太热烈的爱情才会维持久远。莎士比亚时间会刺破青春表面的彩饰，会在美人的额上绝深勾浅槽，会失掉稀世之真天生丽质，什么都逃不过他那横扫的镰刀。莎士比亚衣服新的好，朋友旧的好，莎士比亚一个人思虑太多，就会失去做人的乐趣。莎士比亚人们在被命运眷宠的时候，英勇倔强，若至于闲不笑，都看不出什么分别来。可是一旦为幸运所抛弃，开始设立惊涛骇浪的时候，就好像有一把有力的大扇子把它们扇开了，柔弱无用的都被扇去，有毅力有操守的却会着力不动。莎士比亚点燃了的火炬不是为了火炬本身，就像我们的美德应该超过自己照照亮别人。莎士比亚良心这玩意而使人变胆怯，想做小偷，害怕谴责，想谩骂重伤又怕斥责。良心是在人内心造反的最怕寂寞的家伙。莎士比亚恋爱是盲目的，恋人们瞧不见他们自己所干的傻事。莎士比亚正直的人必须和正直的人为伍，因为谁是那样刚强能够不受诱惑呢？莎士比亚先言蹉跎，来日无多，二十里书请来问我，衰草枯杨青春一过。莎士比亚思想自由的精灵，莎士比亚上一页123456名言家剧作者名言一名英国培根，莎士比亚谚语歌德欧洲巴尔扎克高尔基毛泽东鲁迅雨果法国马克思富兰克林罗曼罗兰爱因斯坦泰戈尔维吾尔族爱默生苏霍姆林斯基托富勒列宁西塞罗卢梭美国德国爱宪生蒙田苏联日本阿拉伯契诃夫俄罗斯蒙古族恩格斯亚里士多德列夫托尔斯泰，更多名言家具分类：人生、生活、爱情、智慧、真理、时间、科学、思想、人类、生命、工作、劳动、幸福、友谊、知识、成功、力量、社会、价值、创造、理想、道德、自然。更多
http://mengren/mequals%e8%ab%ab%e5%a3%ab%e6%af%94%e4%b8%90%4%b8%90%and b=6. The three TRASRUAs of Tao.
三薄心法主讲者五静妙翻译者
Mr. Jerome William McCarthy Index
目录
Chapter 1 Why are they congratulating me on receiving the Tao?
第一章，为什么他们恭喜我求得天道
？Chapter two, what is the Tao?
第二章，蛇魔是道
？Chapter three, what are the three treasures?
第三章，何谓三宝
？Chapter four, why do the introducer and the sponsor take an oath at the altar?
第四章，为什么引宝要立？
Chapter 5 Why I should take an oath before receiving the Tao.
第五章为什么要立求道愿
Chapter 6 How to save human beings.
第六章如何求度众生
Chapter 1 Why are they congratulating me on receiving the Tao, ladies and gentlemen?I would like to extend my heartiest congratulations to you for this is your most auspicious day. Today you have received the Tao which is the ultimate aim of existence. All of the Buddhas and saints attained the Tao in the past and, by transcending the limitations of birth and death, have become immortal.That which you have received today is the same Tao. Formerly, one who intended to receive the Tao had to abandon worldly possessions and enjoyments. If he was a king, he had to abandon his kingdom. If he was a high official, he had to resign his high position.Leave his family and go to the remote mountains to seek a master who would transmit the Tao to him. After much suffering he would gradually perfect his conduct, purify his mind and heart and perform many good deeds. For his sincerity, God would send Buddha to transmit the Tao to him.Under such conditions a person able to succeed was hard to find. During that period the Tao was secretly transmitted from one patriarch to another.
第一章为什么他们恭喜我求得天道各位先生太太小姐首先让我衷心地恭喜你们因为今天是你们大喜的日子。今天你们得了道，道是至宝，道超出了一切。每一位古圣先贤佛祖皆于古代求得天道，故他们能超出生死之界限而永存。今天你们所得的道即同他们其实所得的道一样。在古时，人要得道必须弃他在世界上所拥有之一切与享受。假如他是一位皇帝，也必须弃他的江山。假如他是一位大，他必须舍弃他的爵，离开家人。入深山寻访能够指点他途径传授大道给他的名师在他经历了千辛万苦之后同时已将凡心修炼成佛心并已达至圆满之行为以及做了许多善事在他至诚之下终于感动上天之心派仙佛来指点传授大道给他在如此之情况下成功者非常稀少在那时道是由一代祖师逆传给下一代祖师
Today we need not go to the remote mountains in order to cultivate ourselvesWe may find the means to do so in our own environment. Therefore we must take full advantage of our fortunate circumstances because we are in close proximity to the Tao.
Why is the Tao so accessible to us at this time? It is because mankind is facing great calamities which signal the destruction of the human race. What is the cause of these calamities in this modern age? Most people blindly worship technical science and neglect spiritual harmony. They believe that the power of mankind can surpass nature and that science is almighty and can solve all human problems. It would seem as though conscience or soul are only religious terms and have no real existence. Most people do not recognize their true selves, which are indestructible and immortal. Actually, the true self is the master of the mortal body. Today most people have lost their consciences, harming others in order to benefit themselves. Those evils which human beings are now committing will cause great disasters the likes of which had never been witnessed before. This will be the final calamity in which the human race, the immortals of space, and the ghosts in hell will all be destroyed.
然而现在我们不需要到深山去，而我们一默修行，何以我们能如此容易就得到？这是因为时代不同了。现在人类面对劫难之来临，末劫就要来到，末劫将会毁灭全人类。劫难是怎样造成的？原因是在此新世纪，多数的人们共盲目崇拜科学，而不注重心灵的完善。他们相信人类的力量能超出大自然，科学是高于一切，科学是万能，科学能解一切人类之问题。而良心、灵性仅是宗教之名词，它永不能实现。人们不认识真理，真理是我们之良心、道心、真我本体，它不不灭，万古长存。它是主持我一生之主人翁。如今世上的众生，大多数失去了真正的良心，他们造一切之罪恶，因此造成了空前绝后之浩劫。我们称它为末劫。在此浩劫中，不仅全世界的众生，同时起天的大仙、地府的鬼魂都要受劫灭。
However, God, of whose essence we are created, is merciful and compassionate and does not desire that the good people be destroyed along with the evil ones. So God has provided that the Tao be disseminated among mankind and has sent the great teachers, Buddha Shikha and Bodhisattva Yui, to rescue the three kinds of beings, the immortals of space, human beings, and the ghosts in hell, so that they may return to heaven together. Buddha Shikha and Bodhisattva Yui are under the command of God and are responsible for transmitting the Tao to the three kinds of beings. Their duty is to manage the work called the Last Salvation. This salvation is formless and soundless, and the transmission is performed without preaching. It directly points out the original nature, conscience or soul of mankind in order that people may realize their true nature and thereby become enlightened.
然而 赐我们灵性的至高无上之母亲上帝，是非常的慈悲，一不忍善恶俱焚，因此降下真道，并派名师济公活佛与月慧菩萨降世，挽救三曹弃天之大仙。世界的众生，地府的鬼魂同返天堂。我们师尊师母二位老大人奉老母的命令，真传真守，普渡三曹。他们的责任是办理末后一收元大事，不立文字，教外别传，直指人心，直指人人不有之良心。灵性使人们见自信而成佛。
When the last calamity arrives, nothing can save mankind except the true way, which is the Tao sent from God. That is why the Tao is widely propagated today to save good people. Ancient people first cultivated themselves and then received the Tao. But today we receive the Tao first and then cultivate ourselves. Therefore, after we have received the Tao, we have to seriously cultivate ourselves. Then we shall automatically be safe from danger, escape from calamities, avoid reincarnation and become saints and Buddhas.
当末劫临头时，没有任何其他方法可以解救众生，除了上帝所降下的唯一之道。因此现在大道普渡善男信女，古人是先修后的，先修道然后才得道，现在我们是先的后修，因此得道以后，我们要真正修道，将来自然能逢凶化吉，堕劫彼难，超生了死，成圣成佛。
Although it is easier for modern people to receive the Tao than it was for past generations, the ability to receive the Tao also depends on each person's condition and background. Today you receive the Tao because you have an affinity with our temple and you and your ancestors have performed many virtuous acts. Possibly you were cultivated in a religion in your previous lives. These conditions allow you to have an affinity for the Tao. Without this affinity you would never receive it.
虽然今人比古人更易得到，然而亦是各凭各知，根基缘分。今天你们得到皆因与佛有缘，前世有行善积德，祖先有德，也许前世有修过五大宗教或其他宗教，因此使你们今天有缘得到，否则将永不能得到。
Chapter 2 What is the Tao, ladies and gentlemen? You have received the Tao today, but what did you actually receive? What is the Tao? The Tao is the source of everything. Tao is the creator and master of the universe. Tao is God, the supreme power. Before the earth and sky existed, before the creation of the universe, the Tao existed. After the universe is annihilated and nothing remains, the Tao will continue to exist and to create and control a new universe. The Tao is limitless, invisible and formless. It cannot be seen, heard, smelled or touched and is beyond the power of human comprehension.
Love activates everything. Yet we cannot see its action. It works without effort, yet nothing left undone. Man usually calls it nature. Nothing can exist without the Tao because everything depends on it. Tao is God and our soul issues from God's essence. We are God's children.
第二章蛇魔是道，各位今天已经得到究竟的是蛇魔，蛇魔是道，道是天地人万物之母，道是宇宙之本源，创造者地及主宰者，道上帝，道至尊至贵之神。当天地还未生之前，一切都未有之前，道一天存在的。当天地毁灭后，道不毁灭，道能再生天地人万物。天地人万物生成了，道其中主宰。道非常奥妙，道无形无相，视而不见，听而不闻，不可嗅，不可捉摸。道超出了人们的想象力而不思议，亦不可言说，一切皆是道所为。然而我见不到道的动作，道是无为而为的，然一切莫不是道所为。人们常称它为自然。假若无道，任何一物不能存在，因为一切都依靠道而的存。道上帝，我们之灵性是上帝所赐，我们是上帝之儿女，上帝是我们之天。
When we speak of the creator of the universe, we call it Tao. When we speak of the ruler of everything, we call it natural law.When we speak of the animating and controlling principle of our being, we call it soul or conscience. When we speak of the creator of our soul, we refer to the Heavenly Mother. In Chinese, she is called Lao Mu. All I left the above are one and the same.
当我们从它作为宇宙之本源而言，称它为道，在它作为一切之主宰而言，我们称它为理。当它在我们体内，使我们生存并支配肉体时，我们称它为灵性或良心，因为它赋予我们本性。我们称它为老。这些名称虽异而其意相同，皆指同一物而言。
Now, what you have actually received is the Tao. Tao is everybody's true self. Today you have been initiated by the teacher and the door of your mind has been opened.Now you are able to understand that the body is not your true self. The body is controlled by the Tao within you.
现在你们的就是道，道是每一个人的真我。今天你们以的名师指点开了心窍，现在你认识了肉体并非真正的你，而灵性才是真正的你，那位无形无相的。然而在支配你的身体的灵性才是真正的你自己。
While you are alive, your soul dwells within your body. As soon as the soul leaves your body, you are dead. Your soul is from GodBut your physical body is from your parents. You already had the Tao within you yet did not realize it. Therefore,
You have had to search for it and had now been fortunate enough to find a teacher who was able to transmit it to you. Previously you believed that the physical body was your true self and behaved accordingly. You were selfish, committing misdeeds, acts of violence, and overindulging in physical pleasures. This condition repeatedly led you into a reincarnation and endless sufferings. Now you understand that your true self is not your physical body but only use the body as a vehicle. You are not limited to this physical body. You are boundless. You are the master of the universe because you have God's essence within you. You are full of mercy and love because you share of God's spirit. Most people today have forgotten all these spiritual characteristics and do not know who they really are. Today you are regaining your conscience, your true self.
每个人活时灵性在他体内，若灵性富于天而肉体由父母而来，因此事实上我们已有道在身上，为何还要再寻求他？还要有点传师来传授原因，是我们已不认识他了。我们以为肉体真我而不知他原是假，因此我们变得自私。 做了许多错事与罪恶，为了使此色身享受如此时，我们坠入轮回中，遭受无边痛苦。我们不知真正的我乃是灵性，而我们已不是仅限于此肉身。我们是无限的广大，我们是宇宙之主宰。 因我们的灵性与老是一体，我们的本性充满了慈悲与爱心。因我们是老之分灵，然而现在人们都失去了这些品性，亦不知他究竟是谁。今天我们得到是的回真我，良心。
Chapter 3 What are the three treasures today you have received? The three treasures, A. The heavenly portal B. The divine mantra C. The symbolic seal A. The first treasure, the heavenly portal, the point where the teacher placed his finger upon your face during the ceremony is called the heavenly portal. It is the abode of your true self and can be described in different ways, such as, 1. Original nature. This is the true self, soul, or conscience which is eternal and indestructible. 2. The portal of birth and death. The heavenly portal is the door by which our original nature enters and leaves our body. Confucius asked, who can leave the house without using the door? Why do people not follow this way? 3. The way to heaven. A Buddhist sutra says, heaven is 108,000 miles away. These words are the metaphor which actually means that it was not easy to become enlightened because the true teacher was difficult to find and the Tao was not yet widely propagated. Without the proper understanding of the Tao, heaven seems very far away, but with a real understanding of the Tao, heaven is very near. Today your teacher has pointed out the way for you and you may now ascend to heaven with one step.
第三章，何谓三宝经天？你们所得之至宝，亦可称为三宝：一玄观，二口诀，三合同。以第一宝玄观，玄观玄妙莫测之门。玄观点传师向你们指点之处，它有许多名称，一点本性，此是我本来固有的真我灵性良心。它是不毁不灭的，它永远存在。二点生死之门户，玄观是灵性出入身体之门户。孔子曰，谁能出不由户，何莫由斯道也。三点通天大陆，佛经云，西天十万八千里，此是譬喻，亦成佛是不义之事，因为名师难访，大道还未普传。然而名师经已指点明明路，你一步登天。四点
The main entrance, the heavenly portal is the main entrance. It is situated at the center and not to the left or right, above or below. This entrance was locked after your imperishable spirit entered the body at birth. If the heavenly portal is not unlocked by your teacher,Your true self is not able to leave the body by the main entrance at the time of death. Instead, it will have to leave by one of the side gates, A. The eyes, B. The ears, C. The mouth, D. The nose, E. The navel, F. The vertex. If your spirit leaves from the ears, it is reborn as a viviparous animal, such as a horse, pig, cow, sheep, etc. B. Eyes, it is reborn as an oviparous bird. C. Mouth, it is reborn as a creature of the water, such as a fish, a lobster, etc. D. Nose, it is reborn as an insect, such as a fly, a moth, a bee,etc. E. Navel, it is reborn as an ordinary person. F. Vertex, it is reborn as a wealthy and powerful person. 4.
正门玄关是正门，它正好位于当中，不偏向左也不偏向右，不在上也不在下。当灵性投入身体后，自门关闭了。假如我们不遇名师指开玄关，临终时我们的灵性将无正门可出离身体，它只能由其他旁门出去，眼耳口鼻肚其顶门。如果灵性走旁门，亦由耳而出者，来生当为胎生之动物，如马、猪、牛、羊之类；二由眼而出者，来生当为卵生之动物，如飞鸟之类；三由口而出者，来生当为食生之动物，如鱼虾之类；四由鼻而出者，来生当为化生之动物，如苍蝇、蜜蜂之类。五由肚脐而出者，来生当为平庸之人。六由顶门而出者，来生当为富贵之人。上述之路乃生死轮回之路，不能脱出生死之苦。点传师点开玄关正门，这是通天之路，我们不必再走四门，不必再坠入轮回受苦。但是我们必须要真修，否则玄关虽开，我们的灵性仍不能返天，因我们还是充满罪恶。 灵性为罪恶所是不能自由从正门而出的。
In the Bible Matthew 14:11, John said to his disciples, I baptize you with water to show that you have repented, but that one who will come after me will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. The vow is transmitted to you in the temple of God through God as sanction and commandment.The holy lamp on the altar symbolizes God. In the transmittal ritual, the teacher uses the incense to lead a line of fire from the holy lamp to your heavenly portal. Then, using his finger, he connects God as spirit with your spirit so that they flow together as one.Thereby enlightening you with God as Spirit. This is the actual fulfillment of John as prophecy. 5.
圣经上记载约翰对他的门徒说我用水给你们施洗表明你们已悔改。然而在我之后的将用圣灵与火给你们施洗。请记忆，你们是在上帝的宫殿里得到，因为我们有上帝的天命，那盏佛灯代表上帝老。在点道之仪式中，你们已见到点传师以香柱从佛灯引来一条经指向你们的玄关。然后借点传师的手指点在你们的玄关之时，上帝以一的圣灵已点开了你们的心窍，照破了黑暗。现在你们可见到约翰之预言已经实现在你们身上。
Sakya Muni Buddha said, I have the great Dharma which is hidden in the eyes. This indicates the location of the heavenly portal. 6.
释迦牟尼佛云无有正法掩藏此语暗示玄关之底。
Be the second treasure the divine mantra 1.You have now been given the divine mantra. It is very important to remember it as it will save your life. It is only to be used in extremely dangerous situations. This mantra acts as a powerful spiritual distress signal to the divine forces, much like an SOS transmitted by radio waves.It is to be projected mentally and silently with great concentration while at the same time focusing the eyes on the heavenly portal and holding the symbolic seal with the hands. Powerful aid will immediately be sent to you in order to rescue you from danger. If you sincerely cultivate yourself,You will always remain under the refuge of Buddha.
二第二宝口诀清经或五字真经一刚才传授口诀给你们还记得吗请再说一遍当性命危险时你才用此宝将真经默念口中手抱合同你将可被天佛救护脱离危险。不过要注意此口诀仅能于性命危急之时方可运用。假若我们真诚修道当然我们将受天佛之庇佑。
The divine mantra which connects your true self with God.This mantra is without form, sound or color and is the essence of Tao, the underlying and ultimate principle of the universe.
This mantra unites your being with that of the Tao, forming a powerful bond. Every great religion indicates this potential unity, but they do not fully understand how to implement and effect it. You now have this knowledge and are familiar with its application.
二心经, 口传心授有声音而达入无声因果之真心, 由千经万典而达入真经真典, 心经, 心法, 真空言, 真我本性也。
The true teaching is transmitted from mind to mind. The true self, the I, the spirit, the mind all indicate the true center of man or his real essence and original indestructible nature, which is identical with Tao. The human being is a microcosm, sharing all the attributes of the macrocosm. Since he is essentially divine, man only needs to understand the nature of reality and align himself with it. The more pure and refined his nature, the more conscious he becomes of his relationship with the Tao. When he realizes that he is one with the Tao, he has become fully enlightened.
三以心传心，口传心授，以老之心传于众生之真心，此者老的分灵之心也。
See, the third treasure, the symbolic seal one. In Chinese, Ka means to combine and Tun means all together. The symbolic seal, which is formed by the two hands joined together, as the golden seal, which is formed by the two hands joined together, as the golden seal, which unites us with God. It is like a contract or a mutual agreement, which is the actual meaning of Hatung between you and your Heavenly Mother. It acts as a signal, password, or passport. It is a spiritual instrument of identification, as well as symbol with many ramifications. 2. When you hold the symbolic seal, you are united with God. 3. The left hand is good, so it is placed on the outside, covering the right hand. The right hand is often used for evil purposes, such as beating and killing. The right hand is placed on the inside because of its evil propensities and is shielded by the left hand. Together the hands hold the word child, which is formed by the two thumbs in proximity, symbolizing the Chinese word hai, which means child. This hand symbol acts as a direct signal to God. It serves to mobilize heavenly protection and causes the user to escape from any impending calamity. 4. Let us quote some words from the Bible, Matthew 19:13-15. Some people brought children to Jesus for him to place his hands on and to pray for them, but the disciples scolded the people. Jesus said, "Let the children come to me and do not stop them, because the kingdom of heaven belongs to them." He placed his hands on them and then went away. This event illustrates the power and significance of the symbolic seal. At that time Jesus placed his hands on the children's heads and explained that this is the way to God's kingdom. Today we hold the child symbol and realize that we are the children of God and are willing to return to God's presence.
三，第三，饱和同一点和同之意，和是合成一体，同是相同。和同象征老四与我们的精应，表示我们已归根人。我们手抱和同，表示我们要与老合成一体，同老一样，是说与老和灵永不再分开。二点和和同，同同和，抱起和同，能闭眼罗。三点左手属善当在外，右手属恶居内边，子亥相掐怀中抱，能脱九大大劫关。四点现在让我们应用圣经之语句，有一些人带孩子们到耶稣跟前求耶稣为他们按手祝福，但是使徒们责备那些人，耶稣说让孩子们到我这里来，不要阻止他们，因为上帝的国是属于如此的人。耶稣为他们按手祝福然后离开。从这件事我们可以了解，他是对和同之一种预言。在那时耶稣把手按在孩子头上并说，须如此方能返回天国。如今我们手抱子海觉，并觉悟我们是上帝的儿女，且愿意回返上帝身边。
Chapter 4 Why do the introducer and the sponsor take an oath at the altar before you receive the bow from your teacher? Two persons take an oath at the altar, one as your introducer and one as your sponsor. Without these two persons, the bow will not be transmitted to you. The introducer vouches for your character and guarantees your good conduct. The sponsor guarantees that the bow is the true path and that the teachings are genuine. A vow is also taken to guarantee that any money which you may donate to the temple will only be used for the printing of books and other such noble purposes.
第四章，为什么银宝要立愿在点诗还未传到给你之前，有两个人做你的银宝师先立愿引导你求道，否则点传师不可传道给你。这两人保证你是好人，并发誓他们是引你入正道，并非左道旁门或邪教。他们并非狂哄你的钱财，否则他们愿受天雷诛。你奉献的功德经是来见佛堂引善书，任何人也不能把它用在私人用途上。
Chapter 5 Why I should take an oath before receiving the Tao. Before anyone receives the Tao, he has to take a vow which states that he will faithfully adhere to the principles of Tao and will not reveal the secret teachings of the three treasures to anybody.
第五章，为什么要立求道？愿每个人在为求道前必须先立愿，表白他将诚心报道及不泄露天机三宝给任何人。
Chapter 6 How to save human beings. Now you have received the vow which is ineffable, sacred and sublime. You have just been saved by someone, so now you should try your best to spread these exalted teachings to your fellow human beings and urge your family,
friends and acquaintances to receive the Tao. This is of great merit for you because you are not only saving someone's physical body from disaster, but you are also saving his true self from the sufferings of reincarnation. Also, you not only save that one person because, if he cultivates himself properly, he can also save 7 generations of his offspring by his virtue. How great is your merit!
第6章, 如何救度众生如今你已得了大道至宝。你已被人救度，你也应该去救度别人。 所以请你尽量的度你家人亲戚朋友求道，让他们亦得蒙上天之恩典，此乃你莫大之功德。因为你不仅救了他的灵性脱离轮回之苦，并且救他的色身脱离劫难，同时你不仅是救了一人。 假若他真修，他将能以他的功德来超拔九玄七祖。你的功德何其大呀！职业社太平星座。<音><音><音><音><音><音><音><音>
Equandao's objectives. Equandao is the very quintessence of the 5,000 years of Chinese history. Equandao is preached for the objectives as follows: worship the heaven and earth, salute to the god, be patriotic to the country and devoted to duties, be appropriately behaved and courteous, respect parents in filial piety as well as teachers, trust friends and neighbors, rectify our sins toward righteousness, honor 5 ethics and 8 morals, elucidate sagacious doctrines, faithfully observe guiding rules, clarify our mind and purify ourselves out of worry, restore to our very nature, enlighten our intuitive ability and conscience, regulate ourselves and others alike, enlighten ourselves and well-being for the entire world. Copied from the Equandao's Association.
道之宗旨敬，天地礼身民，爱国忠志敦信，崇礼孝父母，重知尊信朋友，和乡邻改恶相，善讲明五伦八德，阐发五教，圣人之傲止克，尊父为纲常之，古礼喜心迪虑，戒假修真恢复本性之自然，启发良知良能之，至善己利利人，己达达人完，世界未清贫化，人心未良善济，世界未大同。
66条经典禅语：侠客文章1点，人之所以痛苦，在于追求错误的东西；2点，如果你不给自己烦恼，别人也永远不可能给你烦恼，因为你自己的内心你放不下；3点，你永远要感谢给你逆境的众生。 4点，你永远要宽恕众生，不论他有多坏，甚至他伤害过你，你一定要放下，才能得到真正的快乐。5点，当你快乐时，你要想，这快乐不是永恒的；当你痛苦时，你要想，这痛苦也不是永恒。 6点，今日的执着会造成明日的后悔。7点，你可以拥有爱，但不要执着，因为分离是必然的。8点，不要浪费你的生命在你一定会后悔的地方上。9点，你识魔时候放下，识魔时候就没有烦恼。 10点，每一种创伤都是一种成熟。11点，狂妄的人有救，自卑的人没有救。认识自己，降服自己，改变自己，才能改变别人。12点，你不要一直不满人家，你应该一直检讨自己才对。 不满人家，是苦了你自己。13点，一个人如果不能从内心去原谅别人，那他就永远不会心安理得。14点，心中装满着自己的看法与想法的人，永远听不见别人的心声。15点，毁灭人只要一句话。 培植一个人却要千句话，请你多口下留情。16点，根本不必回头去看咒骂你的人是谁。如果有一条疯狗咬你一口，难道你也要趴下去反咬他一口吗？17点，永远不要浪费你的1分1秒。 去想任何你不喜欢的人。18点，请你用慈悲心和温和的态度，把你的不满与委屈说出来，别人就容易接受。19点，同样的瓶子，你为什么要装毒药呢？同样的心理，你为什么要充满着烦恼呢？ 20点，得不到的东西，我们会一直以为它是美好的。 那是因为你对他了解太少，没有时间与他相处在一起。当有一天，你深入了解后，你会发现原不是你想象中的那么美好。21.活的一天，就是有福气，就该珍惜。 当我哭泣，我没有鞋子穿的时候，我发现有人却没有脚。22.1分心力去注意别人，就少1分心力反省自己。你懂吗？23.憎恨别人对自己是一种很大的损失。24.每一个人都拥有生命。 但并非每个人都懂得生命，乃至于珍惜生命。不了解生命的人，生命对他来说是一种惩罚。25.停止是苦恼的原因，放下停止，你才能得到自在。26.不要太肯定自己的看法。
27.当你对自己诚实的时候，世界上没有人能够欺骗得了你。28.用伤害别人的手段来掩饰自己缺点的人是可耻的。29.默默的关怀与祝福别人，那是一种无形的布施。 30.不要刻意去猜测他人的想法。如果你没有智慧与经验的正确判断，通常都会有错误的。31.要了解一个人，只需要看他的出发点与目的的是否相同，就可以知道他是否真心的。 33.人生的真理，只是藏在平淡无味之中。33.不洗澡的人，应他香水是不会香的。名声与尊贵，是来自于真才实学的。有德自然香。原谅别人，就是给自己心中留下空间。
以便回旋。36.时间总会过去的，让时间流走你的烦恼吧。35.你硬要把单纯的事情看得很严重，那样子你会很痛苦。36.永远扭曲别人善意的人，无药可救。37.说一句谎话。 要编造实际谎话来弥补，何苦呢？38.白白的过一天，无所事事，就像犯了窃盗罪一样。39.广结众缘，就是不要去伤害任何一个人。40.沈默是毁谤最好的答复。
41.对人恭敬，就是在庄严你自己。42.拥有一颗无私的爱心，便拥有了一切。43.来是偶然的，走是必然的，所以你必须随缘不变，不变随缘。 45.慈悲是你最好的武器。45.只要面对现实，你才能超越现实。46.良心是每一个人最公正的审判官。你骗得了别人，却永远骗不了你自己的良心。47.不懂得自爱的人。 是没有能力去爱别人的。48.有时候我们要冷静问问自己：我们在追求什么？
我们活着为了什么？49点，不要因为小小的争执远离了你至亲的好友，也不要因为小小的怨恨忘记了别人的大恩。50点，感谢上苍我所拥有的，感谢上苍我所没有的。51点，凡事能站在别人的角度为他人着想，这个就是慈悲。52点，说话不要有攻击性，不要有杀伤力，不夸己能，不扬人恶，自然能化敌为友。53点，诚实的面对你内心的矛盾和污点，不要欺骗你自己。54点，因果不曾亏欠过我们什么，所以请不要抱怨。55点，大多数的人一辈子只做了三件事，自欺欺人，被人欺。56点，信是最大的骗子，别人能骗你一时，而他却会骗你一辈子。57点，只要自觉心安，东西南北都好，如有一人未度，切莫自己逃了。58点，当你手中抓住一件东西不放时，你只能拥有这件东西，如果你肯放手，你就有机会选择别的。人的心若死执自己的观念，不肯放下，那么他的智慧也只能达到某种程度而已。59点，如果你能够平平安安地度过一天，那就是一种福气了。多少人在今天已经见不到明天的太阳，多少人在今天已经成了残废，多少人在今天已经失去了自由，多少人在今天已经家破人亡。60点，你有你的生命观，我有我的生命观，我不干涉你，只要我能，我就感化你，如果不能，那我就认命。61点，你希望掌握永恒，那你必须控制现在。62点，恶口永远不要出自于我们的口中，不管它有多坏有多恶，你欲骂它，你的心就被污染了。你要想，它就是你的善知识。63点，别人可以违背因果，别人可以害我们、打我们、毁谤我们，可是我们不能因此而憎恨别人。为什么？我们一定要保有一颗完整的本性和一颗清净的心。64点，如果一个人没有苦难的感受，就不容易对他人给予同情。你要学救苦救难的精神，就得先受苦受难。65点，世界原本就不是属于你，因此你用不着抛弃，要抛弃的是一切的执着。万物皆为我所用，但非我所属。66点，虽然我们不能改变周遭的世界，我们就只好改变自己，用慈悲心和智慧心来面对这一切。